ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీ రామానంద పరబ్రహ్మ నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీ శివానంద పరబ్రహ్మ నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీకృష్ణ పరమాత్మ నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీ శంకర భగవత్పాదాచార్యుడే నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీ వ్యాదివ్యాస భట్టారకాయ నమః. ఓం సద్గురు శ్రీ నిత్యానంద పరబ్రహ్మ నమః. గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ ఎవ్రీబడి హు పార్టిసిపేటెడ్ ఇన్ ది కాన్ఫరెన్స్. టుడేస్ టాపిక్ ఈజ్ శరీర. శరీర మీన్స్ బాడీ. దిస్ బాడీ ఈజ్ అదర్వైజ్ కాల్డ్ శరీర. శిరియతే ఇది శరీర. దట్ విచ్ డిసింటిగ్రేట్స్ అండ్ డిసపియర్స్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ శరీర. దిస్ ఇస్ అదర్వైజ్ కాల్డ్ దేహ. దేహ మీన్స్ దహ్యతే ఇది దేహ. దట్ ఈస్ దట్ విచ్ ఈజ్ బర్న్డ్. This is burnt by the Jeeva Shakti life force which is coming down in the form of heat and it is burning the body. So that's why it is called Dehaha. This body is very important to achieve the eternal knowledge. The spiritual knowledge, this is very important. This is the main platform. Are basic basis for to achieve the spiritual knowledge. This is in Vedas it is called Sarira Majyam Khalu Dharma Sadhanam. To achieve knowledge, one's body is a must. It should be very healthy. So to become healthy, to sustain this body in a healthy manner, body requires two things. One is glucose, another is oxygen. Every cell requires oxygen and glucose. Of course, we will supply glucose by means of food. But oxygen, what we mean is, oxygen means we are thinking that this external oxygen. This external oxygen is only acting as a catalyst, but there is another prana shakti inside our body that is essential for sustenance of this body. That internal prana shakti is quite different from this external oxygen. This oxygen is only an inorganic gas, whereas internal pranam is a divine prana shakti which is also necessary for the sustenance of keeping the body healthier. So, in every minute, every respiration, we are exhausting spiritual energy. So, if you want to keep the body, you have to supply the every cell with this spiritual pranic shakti, prana shakti. That's why this body is again made of three types: Sola Deha, Soshma Deha, and Karana Deha. This grass body is fed by food. This is called Annamaya Deha, Annamaya Kosha, Ramanamaya Deha. Another body is subtle body, Soshma Deha, that is there in the Swapnavastha. Swapnavastha means during dreamful state. In that we are having three koshas: pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya kosha. And in the deep sleep state we will go to causal body. That is, causal body means which is responsible for our rebirth. That causal body contains all the previous material impressions, whether good or bad, they are located in the causal body, which is the body responsible for our rebirth. So from that body we are coming to this grass body. This body, grass body, has to be sustained by taking food and oxygen. Here this body made of cells, every cell has to be nourished by glucose and oxygen. But we are supplying food. But to digest this food, you have to have the sufficient prana shakti inside. What we are taking food is to be digested only by the prana shakti inside. That is called, what we call is jatragni, or jatragni. This jatragni, in scientific way, we say it contains some digestive enzymes. In the saliva, it contains ptyalin. In the stomach, amylase, lipase, hydrochloric acid, and all these digestive enzymes. All these put together, we call it as jatragni. This agni, why we are calling it as agni means, it depends upon the movement of the life force within our body. When it is goes upward, this agni will be more. When it goes down more, this agni will be diminished. That's why to increase the jatragni, you have to take your life force upwards. If you want to take our life force upwards, you have to churn it. You churn the life force by up and down movements. By churning, you will get heated up. That heat is jatragni. That's why a yogi can easily digest the food. Whatever the food we take, some amount of food will be converted into energy, rest of it will be converted into debris, what you call impurities. So impurities will be minimized when we increase the jatragni. That is, that can be done by pranayama. Of course, this body can be sustained by three types of exercises. One is ordinary bodily exercise, another is yogasanas, the third one is pranayama. The bodily exercise will remove the excess fat and water, everything, by doing ordinary exercise. But it will never generate the prana shakti inside. During this yogasanas, it also never generated energy, but it is useful to circulate the whatever the life force or energy there available in the body uniformly throughout it will circulate. So yogasanas are useful for uniform circulation of the vital force. But whereas pranayama, it will generate the energy, generate the life force. Thereby, every nook and corner of the body will get this oxygenated blood. That's why pranayama is the best method for microcirculation. Microcirculation means every capillary, minute blood vessel, that is called capillary. The blood will go through every capillary. That's why if you do pranayama, this jatragni will digest the food and convert this into energy. That energy will pass through each and every capillary that will stimulate all the cells, especially neurons in the brain. Our brain now is functioning to some extent only. But if you supply this generated pranic shakti, you can stimulate the brain. By stimulating the brain, you will get the wisdom or spiritual knowledge. That's why to get this spiritual knowledge, you have to sustain this body. You have to maintain this body. So, daily if you do this pranayama, your food intake will be mostly digested. That will be converted into energy. But for an ordinary man, this digestion of food will be less. Thereby, there will be much impurities. These impurities cause hindrance to the blood circulation. So, these impurities, when they are blocked in every part of the body, we will call it as a certain disease. We will name certain disease on that particular system, on that particular organ. So when the blood supply is, blood circulation is slow, then it will be converted into blood clot. Blood clot means thrombosis. If it is that clot happens in the heart, we call it as myocardial infarction or heart attack. If it blocks in the brain, it causes paralysis. Like that, if it causes anywhere block, we will call a certain disease, name it a certain disease, and we will resort for some special medicines. But there is only one disease, that is deficiency of chronic energy. That energy, if there is less, there will be hampering in the blood circulation, there will be causing all the diseases. So there is only medicine, one medicine to increase the chronic shakti, vital energy. Otherwise called, it is called mental energy, otherwise it is called spiritual energy. If you increase this energy, both mind and the body, they will become sound health and sound mind. This is the only one remedy which can act both physically and mentally. That's why disease means dis-ease. This means difficulty. Ease means easy. Ease means easy. So the life force which is coming down from the brain, going to the peripheral parts of the body, again it is trying to go upwards. When it is trying to go upwards, the food we are taking, the impurities came out in while taking food, while digesting food, these impurities will block the return flow of the blood to the brain. So it is not easily going upwards. When it is not going easily upwards, that is called dis-ease. That is called disease. So there is only one disease, that is slowing or hampering of blood circulation. Here in this pranayama, we are increasing blood circulation like anything. There is one medical term called peripheral venous return. Peripheral venous return means the heart pumps the blood to the other parts of the body, but the blood will return without any pumping from the periphery, only by sucking force. That sucking force are otherwise called vacuum or negative pressure that is there in the lungs. That is called responsible for the return, venous return of the blood. So if you increase this venous return by increasing the vacuum or negative pressure in the lungs by doing pranayama, more venous return, that will cause free circulation to each and every part of the body. When there is free circulation, there is no disease at all. Like that, you can sustain this body for a longer period. That's why your yogi can keep his body for a longer time. Not by just keeping the body for a longer time, his cells, brain cells will be going on stimulating, so he will know the fact, which is whether what we are seeing this universe, whether it is Brahman or God or universal spirit. But at present, our brain is functioning to a limited extent. It is not working. So a yogi will be always alert. He can know the fact. So to get rid of the disease, or to get rid of the physical or mental disease, or to get the spiritual knowledge, pranayama is a must. It is the best resort for each and everybody. Understand? The other thing is, the body, what we got is a very, very precious body. You know, every jiva or every soul is routinely transferring from one birth to another birth in 84 lakh races. At one chance, we are getting this human body. But if you don't utilize the opportunity to reach the eternal goal by doing sadhana. With this body, again we will miss the chance and there is a big cycle. To get the human body, there are only two chances. One is routine chance after getting 84 lakh races, but the other is Yoga Bhrashta. Yoga Bhrashta, that is there in Bhagavad Gita 6th chapter, Yoga Bhrashto Vijayate. That means if you do a little pranayama in this human form with this birth, if you cannot fulfill this, even if you don't fulfill this, if you leave this body, again you will be born as human body as Yoga Bhrashta, and you will continue it. That is the main essence of this pranayama. Even if you don't fulfill this, even during this death, if you will get again rebirth as human form and you will continue this. That is the main. Whereas for other, there is no chance at all because they don't have a sufficient spiritual knowledge. That's why a yogic body will be like a ripened fruit, whereas a non-yogic body is an unripened fruit. Apakva paripakvas dehina dividasmata apakva yogahinasu pakva yogena dehinaha. The yogic body is pakvam. Pakvam means ripened fruit. Ripened fruit means it will be full of energy, ripened. Whereas a non-yogic body is like an unripened fruit. When you leave this unripened fruit, then naturally you will be succumbed for diseases and you don't get this human birth also in the next birth. But this human yogic body, when it is fully ripened, there is no rebirth at all. But there is some gap, there is some remnants, then you will continue as Yoga Bhrashta. So that's why there is one slokam Padma Purana says, Punagramam, Punakshatram, Punarvittam, Punagruham, Punasubhasubha Karma, Nasariram, Punapuraha. If you lose land, doesn't matter, if you lose land, if you lose house, if you lose our money, if you lose body, if you lose all these things, even if you lose good or bad karmas, doesn't matter, they will be regained. You can get it. But if you lose this own form, it is very difficult to get it. That's why all scriptures says, be careful and utilize this human body and try to sustain this body by doing yoga sadhana or pranayama. So, for a spiritual aspirant, the sustenance of the human body is very, very important. You see the importance of the body for today.